welcome to Skylark Church Soundbites. Now, tonight I am in my car because I found it is another space where I can sneak off to and it is quiet. I am sure that my house is like so many others where there are children, in that most of the floors are often covered in Lego. Tiny little pieces of plastic just there waiting to be trodden on, or even worse, knelt on. But not ever by the children. No, it's only ever by me. They somehow avoid it after they've beautifully and creatively spread it across the room. Now, most of the Lego in our house has come from a kit, something that they followed instructions and made, and then it just goes into this big generic bucket of Lego. But one thing I love to do is watch as they create something from all these different generic bricks, something unique, something individual. And often what they start off making, what their idea that they start with, often looks quite different at the end. Now, we've heard lots recently about metaphorically building bridges. It's something that as a church is really important to us, and as a network, the idea of crossing over the divide to unite and to restore. And I was reading in a book this week, as I sometimes get to do, and there was a line that just really stood out to me and made me stop and think, and it was simply this: surely building a bridge is better than building a wall. And it made me think, what if I think I'm building a bridge, I think I'm uniting, but actually I'm ending up building a wall? How would I ever know? And then I thought, well, actually, one thing I could do, one question I could ask myself to save me from one day looking up from where I think I have been building a bridge, where I think I've been crossing a divide, where I think I've been uniting, only to find myself faced with a wall. One question I could ask myself is what I'm doing or what I'm saying uniting or isolating? Because that's probably a good indicator as to whether or not I'm building bridges or building a wall. Is what I'm saying and doing empowering those around me, or is it shutting them down? Am I understanding others well enough, or deferring to I know best? Am I being allowed to be taken out of my comfort zone with grace and humility? Or am I letting my decisions come out of a place of insecurity? Because building bridges has got to be better than building walls. Even if those bridges are rickety and unstable and they need underpinning and reinforcing to make stronger, let's make sure that we're humble enough to keep ourselves in check, to make sure it's a bridge that we're building and not a wall. Pray that you have a great week and a great rest of your evening.